So the upper end, lower end, and this is the meniscus. So the bone end is lined with a soft lining cartilage. This is a lining cartilage. So if cartilage gets worn out, that is known as arthritis. This is normal cartilage, now it has become arthritic. So why cartilage becomes arthritic? These are the reasons: injury, trauma, chronic injury like ligament tears, meniscus tear, there is a cushion tears, cartilage diseases, variceness that now Dr. Anand Joshi was talking about, early bowing causes, predisposes to arthritis, or genetic predisposition. So how to treat this cartilage problem? There are three ways. Of course, we try first medical line, any knee pain, by reducing weight, doing exercises and all this. And operating on this, drilling the bone, we get fibrous cartilage, or we can transplant the cartilage, normal cartilage to the non-weight-bearing cartilage, non-weight-bearing to weight-bearing, or we can put chondrocytes implantation. So if you put a, this is a macro fracture, the clot it forms, it becomes the fibrous cartilage, it is not durable, it will be there for 2 years, or we can do non-weight bearing cartilage transfer to the weight bearing area, but you can do in small defects, they got this morbidity. So coming to cartilage implantation, older generation, they used to take biopsy first, for culture for 6 weeks, then implant. So this is the case of a cartilage defect. This is a biopsy. Once the biopsy, we take arthroscopic, which we have been doing for past 12 years. And that piece is sent for culture for 6 weeks. And second stage, we do a mini open incision. This is the old technique. Now we are going to talk new technique. And we put that grown chondrocytes. 2 years follow-up. This is a small incision. Earlier we used to do with mini incision. So this is a post-op MRI. Cartilage defect, cartilage, new cartilage. So now what our focus is, now what you are talking in this conference, is single stage cartilage transfer. We take bone marrow, which contains the stem cells, mesenchymal stem cells, from the waste bone, and we prepare the clot, concentrated BMAC, bone marrow aspirating clot, and we implant it. This is the clot we make. So what is aspiration from the waste bone, stem cells, we prepare it, and we implant at same setting. So from the waste bone, we take around 60 ml of bone marrow, prepare the bone marrow, concentrate. These are the various process steps. So this is the, we take the concentrated bone, mononuclear defect is prepared, and that concentrated bone marrow, concentrate as, which has been converted to a clot, is going to be implanted. That is bone marrow aspirate concentrate. And coming to second topic, meniscal cushion, I was talking earlier, I showed the between two bones, it acts like a cushion. These are the various functions. So earlier we used to remove the meniscus, meniscectomy, but now we try to preserve the meniscus, because if you remove the meniscus, there will be more chance of osteoarthritis, because the two bones are going to touch. So earlier, around 15 years, I used to do regularly remove the meniscus, any surgeons. So if you remove the meniscus, for time being he may be normal, but after 10 years, he'll go for arthritis. So some meniscus tears, especially which are repairable, we have to repair. Only outer one-third is vascular. In the Congress, we have showed this meniscus tear repair techniques. So we are preserving the meniscus cushion. So there are various technique devices to repair the meniscus. From the meniscus is a C-shaped structure. So we repair the meniscus for using different instruments. That's why we are teaching the, our orthopedic surgeons. This is after meniscus repair. Now we have got newer instruments, advanced techniques to do the meniscus repair. Earlier we used to do with needles. Now that its speed since has come, we can do the meniscus repair much faster. That's why remove the meniscus very carefully. If it is repairable, try to repair it.